Hi, welcome back to Body Beautiful. We are here with plastic surgeon Dr. Joseph Mele talking about all kinds of procedures. And right now we are going to talk about the eyelid lift. Very popular procedure, right,
Doctor?
Very popular.
One of the most popular.
Wow. All right, let's get right into the pictures because people love the before and after. Picture number one, what's going on here?
So this is someone who had sort of heavy upper eyelids and then little bags underneath the eyes. So I've done upper and lower blepharoplasty in order to reduce the extra skin on the upper lid and unpack the lower lids.
I don't see any scars. Where are the scars?
So the scars are right there. There's one right in the fold, and it extends laterally outside a little bit. And the one underneath the eyelids is right underneath the lashes.
Fantastic and very natural. I mean, that's kind of difficult because you got to get the excess skin without taking too much.
Yeah, because it's easy to distort. The eyelids are movable, they're soft,
exactly.
And if you pull on them the wrong way, they go the wrong way.
All right, let's go to picture number two. What's happening in this picture?
Sure, it's kind of similar. So she had very heavy upper eyelids.
Yeah.
And a lot of folks are just born that way.
Yes,
this isn't
exactly.
Something that developed over time. Even when she was younger, she had kind of had this no space between the lashes and the eyelid.
But you kind of need a surgery because it could hinder your sight, could it not?
It can block your vision up, and sometimes where it hangs to the side, it blocks the side vision.
Mm-hmm.
And in her case, it made it really hard to wear eye makeup.
All right, let's say somebody had uppers and lowers done. What is your recovery time on that?
Recovery time is really for the bruising to go away. It takes a week to 10 days, somewhere in that range. Not usually painful. The eyes feel tired, mm-hmm. more and dry maybe. But they shouldn't be painful.
Very beautiful and natural after picture on that
one. So you can see her crease now. You can see space between
her eyelashes.
You can
see the crease, exactly. It's so perfect, but just very subtle. Looks fantastic. Picture number three.
Okay, less subtle increase, because mm-hmm. here she's got skin that's hanging and pushing
yes.
onto her eyelashes. And that's when it feels heavy. So mm-hmm. when people have that, they just want it to go away.
Exactly. Do you do this under general anesthesia?
I do it under general, but also under local. It depends on
the
patient.
Okay.
You know, patient doesn't require a lot of motivation, but you got to be a little motivated to do under local because you're awake and you can kind of see and hear what we're doing. Folks who are quite nervous, we just do it under general anesthesia and they don't have to worry about any of the stuff in the middle.
Is the best candidate just somebody with the excess skin?
Excess skin and otherwise normal eyes. Someone with super dry eyes
might
require some additional intervention before pursuing this.
Mm-hmm. Because it does make you look a lot less tired.
It really does. It really does. And I've had people who feel like they look exactly the same as before surgery, even though we've made a dramatic change.
Exactly.
Because they still look like themselves. But then they notice people don't ask them if they're tired. And
that's so
really
true.
Nice.
Tired anymore. Thank you. Did I?
Yes.
And men and women come in for the surgery, doctor?
Men and women. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's go to the last picture. What's going on here?
So here, this is a young woman who still has space, but her
yeah.
eyelid folds are a little uneven. She has multiple folds in the skin, and she just wanted all that cleaned up and smoothed mm-hmm. out.
Now, a lot of people think I might get the uppers done or the lowers. That's way too much. Can you do uppers and lowers at the same time?
Yeah, often I'm doing uppers or lowers because sometimes, one of them will age faster than the other.
Mm-hmm.
If they both have aging, then we always discuss whether to do it together or not.
Gotcha.
I just don't want to do one lid and then have someone come back and say, yeah, that lid looks great, but why didn't you tell me I'd be staring at my other lid now?
Exactly.
So, yeah, balance is very important.
And then you say there's a lot of bruising after the surgery.
It's variable. Some people don't bruise, but I always give worst case scenario, usually 7 to 10 days is the worst.
And swelling, is that a problem?
Swelling peaks a day or two out and then usually resolves pretty quickly also. It's kind of, if you ever played sports, get hit in the eye.
Yeah.
It's kind of similar.
Kind of similar to that. So you could go back to work, but you might just have to cover something up a little bit. But I mean, the recovery time is pretty quick on this.
Yes. And unfortunately with COVID, we don't wear our masks that high.
Oh, that's right. We have the mask. That's too bad.
So,
huh?
The eyes are really important now.
That's so true. That's true. They're even more important now. All right. If you want more information on this procedure or any other procedures we talked about here today on Body Beautiful, just give the doctor's office a call, 925-943-6353. You can see all the before and after pictures on the web too, drmele.com or sanfranciscobreast.com. Lots more coming up on Dr. Mele's 50th Body Beautiful show. Stay right here.